Hey YouTube, so this is gonna be the weirdest empties video I've ever done. This is coming to you from airport carpet. I'm also currently wearing the heaviest clothes I could find, and I'm blazing hot in Philadelphia in the summer wearing rain boots and pants and a giant sweater for no reason. But anyways, because I'm a crazy person, I brought empty stuff with me to the airport because literally to the last second coming out of our house. So one big huge empty this month is my freaking apartment. We moved out. This is it, guys. We're going to freaking San Francisco. So let me talk you through products that didn't make the cut of the move. It wasn't worth it to me to move them, or I used them up. So let's do it. First off, we got the Emma Hardy Amazing Face Natural Lift and Sculpt Moringa Cleansing Balm. Love this stuff. I also used up a tube in California, which I guess will be in my next month's empty. And I just love this. I will constantly use this. I've already repurchased, and I just love this. I think I have a blog post on, I don't know, we'll see. I used up the P50V from Biologique Recharge, I believe. And this is the 1970 version with phenol. I think that's how it's pronounced. And so I went and got a facial at Rittenhouse Rescue Spa. And she said, you can go with a regular P50. So I guess the P50V is maybe for a little bit more sensitive skin, but she was like, your skin can handle it. So super glad I didn't repurchase, and I ended up buying a Biologique mask that I actually had a sample for. It smells terrible, but apparently it's really nice. And I bought a big bottle of the P50, the 1970 version, and then maybe in a little bit I'll get the new version and just see what I think about the two. This is a Juice Beauty Blemish Clearing Cleanser. Didn't completely use this up, but you know, this is not going to make the cut to fly to California. Didn't really think this was that great of a cleanser. Probably won't be purchasing it again. Kind of relegated it to becoming a body wash by the end. Whatever. This is actually still somewhat full, but I'm just getting rid of it. This is an enzyme exfoliating cream mask. Oh, we got people coming in with luggage. This is so weird. And I'm doing this at the airport because crazy. This was like one of those exfoliating, I don't know, nothing to say about that. Used up some Bioderma, love this stuff, and will repurchase for a very long time until I really find an eye makeup remover that's better. Here is an eye makeup remover that still has some in it, but that's not making the cut. I'm not going to take that with me. I don't really think it's that great. It says it's oil free, but it feels so greasy on my eyes that I really just dislike it a lot. I'm not quite sure what this is, but it's something my brother made me, so I'm sorry, but that has to go. This is a This is a vitamin C revitalizing eye cream from Avalon Organics. I've been using this the past 2 weeks when I've been in Philly, and I don't know, it's just nothing great. I'm not going to bring this with me. I want to use more intense eye creams than an organic one. I think I want chemicals all over my little fine lines. Yeah, so this is going to go. Another thing that I'm not quite sure what it is. I think this was massage oil. Or this looks like powder. I'm not sure. Sorry to my brother for not using his stuff. This is a Caudalie Venusaur SOS Thirst Quenching Serum. I had it upside down trying to soak up the last little bits from the sides, but this stuff is great. I don't know if I love the Hyaluron more than this. I'm thinking that I do, especially given the price tag, and apparently it's coming to Walgreens. So I don't normally shop at a Walgreens, but I will definitely do that to get the Hyaluron, though it probably will be a long time before I need to purchase that. But this stuff runs out really quickly. I already have another bottle that I have bought, so it's good enough to repurchase. Gets that stamp. Then we have, this was full of sesame oil, and I use this just for hair treatments. Don't soak your hair completely to the point where you look totally like you just got out of a shower, because it's gonna be hard to wash off. I realized that. I just soaked my head completely for like an hour while I was packing some boxes. I took a shower, I think I only shampooed once, and my hair felt kind of stringy and greasy like when I got out, so that was my mistake. And then I put on too much hair oil after that, so you know, experiments and failure. Oh, this was just a jar of, I couldn't tell you, and that's why I'm not really paying attention to it, because I don't know what I put in this jar. Who knows? Yeah, I really have no clue what that is. This was a concoction that my brother had given me, so I never ended up using that. This is Olé Biologique Olé Moderne, but I actually kept some different oil in this just for travel, so I actually didn't use up this exact product. And then Cetaphil also does not make the cut. Sorry, but it's cheap. You can buy it at the drugstore. I'm not about to move that giant Cetaphil across the country. And this last thing from this bag, there's also a gigantic bag, so beware, guys. this video is not over yet. This is made, this is Chelsea's Healing Skin Oil. This was made by my brother's friend Lotus, and it has rose, frankincense, what does that say? Hylacrism, I don't know, lavender, jasmine, calendita, sesame, castor, rosehip, and vitamin E. It says happy birthday. Back around my birthday and when I had my surgery, she made me this oil. She's like really great with making oils and stuff. And so I've been putting this onto my scar, and it's kind of a leaky bottle, so I've already got some on my finger now, which I will wipe onto my scar. But I thought that was really sweet that she made that for my birthday, and I loved it. So Lotus is not watching this, but if she was, I would say thank you, Lotus. So that ends this bag, and I'm gonna go grab my bigger one and continue looking like a complete psychopath talking into a camera about empty things that are in my hand in the fucking departure section of the airport. So, you know, if I end up in a mental hospital, you know why. You saw the signs. Told you guys I was crazy. Okay, Ryan's parents, I was like, you guys, I make these empties videos and I need to do this at the airport because I have to get this done. And they were like, what? Are you insane? Okay, so let's go through this bag. This is a lot of like didn't make the cut kind of things. So here, the Purity Cleanser. I relegated this to a brush cleanser, but I have the Dr. Bronner's, which I prefer. So the Purity is gonna go bye-bye. Oh God, someone coming in with heavy luggage. Once again, at an airport, total psychopath right here. Purity Cleanser. Rachel, makeup never sleeps, I miss you. That's what I think of when I do this. Okay, so Purity Cleanser, just, you know, it's not very pure. Don't use it on your face. Don't buy it, in fact, don't buy it. We got this hand balm. This was actually very nice. I liked it. I thought the packaging was really cute. I kept it next to my table. I just never got through it. I probably have like maybe 5 uses left. The pink grapefruit scent is very nice as well. Not my favorite, but you know, it was a nice scent. And it was very deep moisturizing. So this is a product that I would say don't run out and buy, but it was nice. So if you get it as a gift, use it. Love this. It's been in my favorites, the Moroccan Oil Hydrating Styling Cream. This I actually pretty much used up. And yeah, I love this stuff. I have a blog post about it, which I will link down below. Here we've got, let's just double it up, some Pantene Pro-V shampoo and conditioner. These are like half full, they don't make the cut. This was like my shampoo I would use for like a first shampoo if I had tons of dry shampoo in my hair and it was just like really gross. I would use this. My hand's really red because I'm just like really sweaty. We have 7 bags that we checked on this flight. Like everything we own is either currently in the hands of USPS or Virgin America. So I'm trusting my life with you, Virgin. Don't fuck me over and lose my bags, please. This stuff doesn't make the cut. So leaving it in a trash can at Philadelphia International Airport. As well, the Alba Cocoa Butter Dry Repair Hair Conditioner, as well as the shampoo. This does not make the cut. It's about half used, and I felt that it made my hair feel quite dry and stringy, despite it being a dry repair shampoo. So it made my hair feel drier. This doesn't make the cut just because there's so little of it left, but I love, love, love this nail polish remover. By far, my favorite nail polish remover that I've ever used. Not that I'm like someone who dabbles in nail polish remover, but this one is great. I love the top because you just push, push, push on a little cotton pad. It's super convenient, so get this stuff. I think it's like $8. Love it. Ojan, we used up this me and my other personalities, not Ryan and I, because he uses Head and Shoulders. Okay, so Ojan Damage Reverse. There we go. I was gonna say dry something. Damage Reverse Shampoo and Conditioner. Love this. Totally will repurchase it. And yeah, I used up this whole thing. So these would have made the cut. I would have put them into smaller bottles. So this is good stuff. Love, love, love. I used up a box of Q-tips. You know what? I would freaking kill for a Q-tip right now. I haven't had Q-tips in like a week. I'm feeling so waxy. Not a fun thing. I know people say don't use them in your ears, you're gonna die, but it's worth it. Love that Q-tip feeling. This was just some conditioner. I forget what exactly it is, so it doesn't make the cut. I don't know. Okay, so now we got some EO Essentials Gentle Revitalizing Shampoo and Conditioner. Grapefruit and mint. The scent was okay. This also made my hair feel a little dry. I haven't had good luck with sulfate-free or like organic shampoos in terms of like being super conditioning. So Not a fan of those. Those don't make the cut. They're about half full. What else we got? This is the Body Shop Candied Ginger Shower Gel. I actually like this. We just weren't gonna take it with us for just the little bit of shower gel that was left in it, so that goes bye-bye. This is the Mrs. Meyers Clean Day Honeysuckle Hand Soap, by far my favorite hand soap. Is that something normal people have, like a favorite hand soap? I do, and it's this Mrs. Meyers stuff, so grab that if you're at the store. Also, we used up the lavender scent, but I still think the honeysuckle is my favorite, and in fact, we left half a bottle of the honeysuckle for our landlord in the apartment, so should have been two honeysuckles in this empty. We've got a Quorez shower gel in jasmine. This smelled really good. They described it as some sort of like vintage floral, and that's totally accurate. It smells really nice, so loving that. Definitely will be using Quorez shower gels in the future. Oh, we got a pause for people who are using the airport for rational reasons, such as departing for flights and not for YouTube videos. So stay tuned, guys. Just wait for those noises to go by. People are looking at me, by the way, but you know what? No shame in the game. Throwing this away because I think it was expired, and I'm trying to get into just physical sunscreens, not chemical ones. I think that was the right way to say that. Used up this Moroccan argan oil, and it was okay. Probably won't purchase it again. I know it's okay, it's good, but I prefer more expensive ones that I have. So, you know, probably not gonna be buying this anymore, but it is a good one for the budget price. So, for value, I guess it's pretty darn good. Cotton Rounds, cool, whatever. Razor, whatever. Some crappy mascaras and some eyeliners that I just don't like. CoverGirl, Maybelline Falsies, I don't like that. It was waterproof. Some CoverGirl Lash Blast Length. They're pretty old, so I should probably just throw them away. I have a giant growing collection of beauty products next to me at the airport. You guys want to see? Like, this is the airport. I'm freaking crazy. Okay, what else do we have? An old Bobbi Brown lip gloss, which I just should toss. This is EOS lotion. There's some gunk on it. We've been moving, like everything's a mess. This is just an EOS hand lotion. I liked it. It smelled nice and it was convenient to keep in the purse. This is the e.l.f. eyebrow kit. I just thought this was crappy. I don't want to take it. And same with the complexion perfection thing. It was like, how do you even, like, I don't even know what you use this for. Let me try to open this with one hand. Like, what do you even use this for? I don't know. I don't know when to use it. Oops, I dropped it. I don't even care. Then what else do we have? We have this Kiehl's Absinthe cream. Whatever, just, you know, a nice cream. Nothing to run home about. Just used up the sample. We have some more Cotton Rounds. We have a very, like, dirty, oily box that I've been keeping this stuff in. And then we have some of the Origins Ginseng Eye Cream, which is okay. I don't think it's anything special. Used up some sample from Olay Biologique, the 004. And this is the little thing that I also used up that I put more oils in from them. So actually, I'm going to keep this because this is really convenient for travel. So don't want to get rid of that. And then this is the Dr. Hauschka's Normalizing Day Oil. There's still some in there, kind of. I didn't like this on my face. I started to break out, I think, after a while of using it. Basically, I just found the Olay one at the same time, so I decided I liked it. But I mean, I liked this when I first started using it, but I just preferred the Olay one when I started that. So this one became a body oil, and it was nice for that. So it's expensive. I think it was like $40 for this bottle. So that was kind of a waste, but it was my first foray into facial oil. So I didn't know what I was doing. Not that it's a bad product. It is a good product, I think. But yeah, I just don't know if it was, you know, the right one for me. I feel like I've said you know a lot in this video. Who knows? Ah, you know, hey, you know. I don't know. This right here is a little grubby, but this is an Olay microdermabrasion treatment. You put this, there's like an orange goo in here, and you put it on your face, and you like scrub it in, and then you'll take this, and it's like an activator serum, and it gets your face really, really warm, and it just feels really nice. But I'm throwing this away because I've owned this for like, I feel like 6 years, and even though it's like half gone through both the products, I just don't feel like I should probably be using this anymore. There has to be some sort of shelf life, and I probably have, you know, surpassed it. We've got Certain Dry here, which will prevent your armpits from sweating completely. It's awesome for that purpose, but it'll probably give you cancer. So I don't recommend buying this because unless you have like a job interview or something that you like really need to make sure that you don't sweat for, use this every night, like 3 days before that, and then you won't sweat through your armpits. I'm a sweaty person. This is so grubby. It's Carol's Daughter Black Vanilla Moisturizing Hair Smoothie. I'm just not gonna finish it. I don't love it. My mom loves it. It's okay, just nothing that I'm excited about. So I'm done with that product. Just a couple more things. We've just got some like drugstore makeup that I don't care about. We got a CoverGirl True Blend and I'm over that. Some Great Lash Mascara, some e.l.f. blush that has like stuff in it. These are some lip stains that I think are just too old now. I've owned them for like over a year. An old Bobbi Brown lip gloss or whatever. What are the last couple things? I think these are more stains. Yeah, and then we have this facial cleanser from Pangea Organics, which I don't think is anything special, and I use it on my body. I just love the Emma Hardy. Like, I'm getting down to the point where it's like, I don't care about testing out other types of skincare just because I love what I'm using so much. Which is great, but kind of not fun at the same time because I really love experimenting. Confession, I used to use this as an eyebrow groomer, and I haven't in like a year, but I found it in my bottom of my drawer when I was cleaning out, and I just, you know, felt the need to confess that to you guys. It's very, very convenient for that purpose. It worked really well, sometimes even better than a little spoolie thing, so get a little travel toothbrush, guys, and you'll thank me later, but how gross, right? It's all brown. And then the last thing is this Aujon Rare Blend, right? Rare something? Rare Blend Oil, there we go. That's the American side. This is the one that's like three different layers and you mix them together. I didn't really think this was that great for my hair, so I'm glad just to have gotten a little sample of it because I was curious about it, but you know, good to know that I don't actually want it. So, Aujon Rare Blend Oil. And this ends the weirdest thing I've ever done in my life, which is bringing trash to the airport and making a video about it. So I call that dedication, and I call it like really concerning in terms of mental health. I like to make jokes about these kind of things, but it's not a joking matter. I'm totally fine, guys. So anyways, I'm just gonna fill up all this garbage back into this bag, and I'm gonna go back to Ryan, and he's gonna be like, are you done yet? I think I want to break up with you and I don't want to move because you're exhibiting signs that you're just going to be a really weird person for forever. But you know what? Life's good. Maybe I should sneak up on him at the airport. Someone is like directly behind me watching me. Think I can get him on camera? No, it's the guy that helped me. I don't want to do it. He might catch me. There he is. So, here we go. We've got these things all in here. I'm gonna take them to the trash can now, and I'm gonna sign off and say bye-bye. Next time you see me, I will be a permanent resident solely of California. Pennsylvania is done and dusted. That chapter is closed. And now I'm gonna throw away my stuff. Bye, guys.